What's that? Yeah.
Big boy, sir, put on a show. Maybe a little sheep boy.
Yeah, we were in it 2 minutes.
Boy, I'm all wet. Yeah, I was a little scared being surrounded by all that food. I didn't realize how loud that was going
to be. Oh, it's deafening, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's 300
PSIs
within that tank.
Yeah, well, I was picking.
So it's crazy.
Yeah, well, I was picking the photos.
Well, I didn't realize I was trying to hold the camera, and finally I was like, I gotta cover you.
Yeah.
I was trying to rotate the camera while taking a picture while plugging my view.
Yeah. All right, dude.
Why was it dripping water back then?
Where?
Back when it was, whenever I first walked in, it was just sitting there, it looked like it was spilling water. Like,
well, I mean, this stuff, you know, it heats up, it expands for that, and like the amount of pressure they have running through some of those lines, I think some of it just drip on. Because like right behind the cab is where they have
they restored the Challenger.
Stuff like that. Uh-huh. So I think that's part of
it. All this stuff off.
That's better. Good
job. Yeah, that's the promontory. We got to meet with the Union Pacific Special Agents. They're the railroad police. They're on the highway. On the track, yeah.
Sometimes they put cameras in between the rails, and those are really cool.
Well, the best thing to do is on these slow moving ones because it doesn't sling it out in the rocks.
From the wall, like, we used to climb up on the railroad yard. We used to climb up on the train and drive the
train.
Yeah. Anyway, one at a time, the train took off and we all started hopping off, doing a head count, and we're like, oh man, where's so-and-so? And we ended up in Mississippi.
A buddy of mine, we live up in France, and all of us kind of had the reputation for doing stuff like that too. And where he lived at, we could hop on the train. Go slow enough to the stern, we can run.